Module 9 is a detailed study of American literature. First one, Out of the Cradle Endlessly Rocking by Walt Whitman. The poem belongs to the Birth of the Poet genre. The poem describes the poet as a young boy watching a pair of mockingbirds nesting on the Pomonok beach. The male bird's cry on the disappearance of its female mate touched the boy's heart, and he seems to be able to translate what the bird is saying. Thus the boy comes of age as a poet. He asks the nature to give him the one word superior to all, and the endlessly rocking waves of the sea tell him death. The poem implies that death is only a natural transition to another life. The transition from the boy to the poet is a transition from a literal experience of life to a spiritual experience. Emily Dickinson's I Felt a Funeral in My Brain exposes a person's intense anguish and suffering as he sinks into a state of extreme madness. She uses the image of a funeral service to symbolize the death of the speaker's sanity. So the poem tells about the collapse of one's mental stability. Her mind is a mess and she is alone, and she must therefore end her existence. The poem expresses a person's loss of connection with reality. Robert Frost's Home Burial is a poem on the death of a child, the collapse of a marriage, and limits of communication. The husband had just returned from burying their young son in a family plot. The husband and the wife grieve in two different ways. The wife, unable to understand his failure to express grief vocally, accuses him of indifference to their loss. The husband considers this as a groundless charge and tries clumsily to assure her. They fail to understand each other and quarrels. Finally, she threatens to leave, while he threatens that he will always follow her and bring her back. Walt Stevens' poem, Sunday Morning, is a meditation on not being a Christian. It centers on a woman who stays at home, lounging around on a Sunday morning, when virtually everyone else is at church. The poem includes a statement that death is a mother of beauty. It is written in blank verse in iambic pentameter, and there are many symbols and images used, like sun, birds, for comfort and peace, freedom, etc. So in the poem, we can see a woman searching for spiritual fulfillment. At the end of the poem, the woman determines that a devotion to earthly pleasures and not the dead religion of the past will provide her with divine bliss. Edgar Allan Poe's The Raven belongs to dark romanticism. It is a reaction to transcendentalism. It is famous for the refrain, "Nevermore." In the poem, we can see a speaker, a man, who pines for his deceased love, Lenore, who has been visited by a talking bird who knows only the word "nevermore." The narrator feels so grieved over the loss of his love that he allows his imagination to transform the bird into a prophet bringing news that the lovers will never more be reunited, not even in heaven. So the raven stands as a symbol of memory, unconsciousness, etc. Themes like madness and despair, death and afterlife, loss and grief are there in this poem. Maya Angelou's poem, Phenomenal Woman, rejects the narrow or cliche expectations of women's beauty. It proposes another perspective or an alternative viewpoint that defines the real beauty. The speaker herself says that she is an extraordinary woman, a phenomenal woman, but she doesn't look like, you know, fashionable women or models. But every single man, you know, desperately comes after her, competes for her attention. So the beauty exists in the way she carries herself. It is all about the confidence and the boldness she shows to the world. It is all about self-acceptance. Eugene O'Neill's play Emperor John's is famous for its expressionistic technique. Emperor John's, Brutus John's, is a main character, and other character is Smithers, Henry Smithers, and a whole group of native tribal people and their chief Lem. So in this play you have to give importance to the expressionistic techniques used by the playwright. That is, there are little formless fears, Jeff, a gang of Negro convicts and a white prison guard, a group of white people, well-to-do planters, an auctioneer and a crowd, two rows of seated Negroes in loincloth, a witch doctor, altar and a crocodile. So all these figures, all these images shows the mental anxiety of Brutus John's. Another thing that we should focus on this play is about the silver bullet and also the tom-tom sound. Tennessee Williams' The Glass Menagerie is a memory play set in St. Louis during the Great Depression. The main characters are Tom Winfield, a merchant sailor. He's an aspiring poet too. His mother Amanda, his sister Laura, who is invalid, and Tom's friend Jim O'Connor. So the play was famous for its on-stage screen and powerful use of music.